down his statues, rename our capital city Sharpton or Mandela, and let the revolution continue. But hold on, not so fast. Changes that profound deserve a debate, not some fake national conversation where they scream commands at you and you get to obey, but a vigorous, reasoned exchange between adults. We wanted to have an exchange like that with Tammy Duckworth tonight. So we called her office and we invited her on the show. Before even considering our request, we must first issue a public apology for criticizing Tammy Duckworth. Yet Duckworth is too afraid to defend her own statements on a cable TV show. What a coward.
Hey everybody, welcome back. Tucker Carlson, the lone mass media voice of reason in the face of a seemingly insurmountable Marxist takeover of this country, has become the latest target of the cancel culture. It really shouldn't surprise anybody because the media and the Democrats always target whoever is the most prominent, most articulate voice of opposition to their agenda. Right now that's Tucker, but they've been going after him a long time. Really, I think ever since that crossfire debate with Jon Stewart, which the left always claims Jon Stewart won, but I disagree. Go back and watch that debate, and what you'll find is Tucker meticulously exposing Jon Stewart as a contradictory hypocrite, with Jon Stewart's only comeback basically being, but I'm a comedian.
And then when they make mistakes.
No, you're not too rough on them. You are part of their strategies. You're partisan, hacks.
Wait, Jon, wait. I want to contrast our questions with some questions you asked John Kerry.
If you want to compare your show to a comedy show, you're more than welcome
here's,
to.
Here's the point. If come on this show, he will come on your show. Let me suggest why he wants to.
Well,
come
we
on
have
this
civilized
show.
Discourse.
Well, here's an example of civilized discourse. Here are three of the questions you asked John Kerry.
Yeah.
You have a chance to interview the Democratic nominee. You ask him mm-hmm. questions such as, quote, how are you holding up? Is it hard not to take the attacks personally?
And there it is. It's different when Jon Stewart does it because he's having civilized discourse. Now, before we get any further into the spew, let me take a quick moment to thank this episode's sponsor, My Patriot Supply. When you see what's going on in our country right now, there's plenty to be concerned about. Social unrest is making life very uncomfortable, and it could quickly get worse. On top of that, a second wave of coronavirus is threatening to devastate our economy and our way of life again. Will we have severe food shortages this time? Will supply chains get cut off if people can't work? Will you even be able to go to the grocery store? These are realistic dangers, so don't let yourself be caught unprepared. Here's what to do right now. Go to www.preparewithdronetek.com and start building your emergency food supply today. The experts at My Patriot Supply are the only people I trust and use. And right now, you can save $100 off a full 4-week supply of delicious, nutritious meals the whole family will love. My Patriot Supply makes it easy to be prepared at all times. And saving $100 off a life-saving 4-week supply of food is too good to pass up. The second half of 2020 is gonna be wild. So go to preparewithdronetek.com and get ready right now. That's preparewithdronetek.com. Do it now. So it's clear to me why Tucker has always been in their sights. He's damn good at arguing against the left's ideologies and their agendas. Tucker is basically the last man standing. Now he's announcing that he's taking a long vacation. Let's hope that he actually returns. That brings us to our favorite dark dimension of pain and suffering, The View, where they are none too happy that Tucker dared to call out Senator Tammy Duckworth for her open support of removing George Washington monuments, something The View has openly supported on their show. During Tucker's critique, he went on to call Duckworth a coward for not appearing on his show to defend her position, something that I would agree with. If you're running for vice president and you're entertaining the idea of tearing down American history only to be replaced by far left Marxists and you will only go on friendly left wing networks, you're a coward. The fact is, she's afraid of scrutiny of her position and will only go on left wing networks that will pat her on the back. Now, the problem arises because Tammy Duckworth isn't just a vet, she's an Iraq war vet who lost both of her legs.
We were just talking about Senator Tammy Duckworth, who was called a coward on Fox News by host Tucker Carlson. Now, Senator Duckworth responded in a quite brilliant op-ed claiming that Tucker Carlson doesn't know what patriotism is.
And there's your lesson on patriotism from Whoopi Goldberg. People who want to tear down American history, which includes the founders, is the height of patriotism, apparently. Anybody who knows anything about me knows that I'm fully supportive of veterans. My dad's a vet, My brother's an Iraq war vet, and I'm a vet myself. However, this can't be used as a shield against scrutiny and criticism, especially when you're a senator who wants to be vice president. Tucker wasn't calling her a coward for anything other than not standing up against the mob and then not appearing on opposition media to defend her position. So let's just get that out of the way right now. What we're seeing here is a favorite tactic of the left, where they will put forward spokespeople who they see as above scrutiny and criticism due to their protected status. Now, of course, this is all tied to partisan politics, because this shield against criticism only works if you're a Democrat or a left-winger. All these protected traits go out the window if you're opposing the left. For example, criticizing Democrat women means you're a sexist. Criticizing non-white Democrat women means you're a sexist and a racist. Criticizing a kid makes you an incel. Criticizing a black president means you're a racist, and so on. Great examples of this are David Hogg, Greta Thunberg, and Barack Obama himself. Remember what happened when a Republican correctly called out Obama for being a liar? That's right, he's a racist.
You don't want to mess with her like this. What do you think?
Well, he's certainly outmatched. I think that what we should call attention to is that he was reacting to a statement that she made when she said that she welcomed a national dialogue on removing some of the statues of not only the founding fathers, but Confederate statues. She welcomed a dialogue. In his response, he called her a fraud, a coward, and someone who hates America. Something else that should be noted is that Tucker Carlson, his head writer, I think his name is Blake Neff, resigned after secretly posting all these racist and sexist, homophobic remarks in an online forum.
Okay. And? You see, this is exactly how they avoid ever having to put forward a convincing argument. They just scream a word at you or a list of words, and that's supposed to mean that you lost the argument. That's why people in the media on the left and in the Democrat Party work so hard to silence people rather than having to defeat them in the arena of ideas. Now, back to this idea that you're crossing some sort of a line if you criticize a veteran. As always, this standard only applies to vets who side with the left. If you're a vet who opposes them, well, then it's open season on you.
Well, I would be remiss if I didn't bring up the fact that, you know, she's a new congresswoman. And on the right, what we have is the president of the United States in Charlottesville saying that there are good people on both sides. Jews will not replace us. They're not good people on both sides.
In that same sentence when he said that, he also said, I am definitely not referring to white nationalists.
Why do you apologize, man?
You have to read what he actually said.
I listened to exactly what he said.
It wasn't in the same sentence. It was actually in a statement 2 days later.
No, it wasn't. So you agreed. No, it wasn't.
Wrong. This is off topic, but as we at this channel have pointed out many times, Donald Trump did condemn them in the exact same speech. And again, look at how they rushed to the defense of a non-veteran Democrat while being openly hostile towards the veteran Republican who lost an eye in combat. Now, back to this supposedly racist, homophobic, sexist writer from the Tucker Carlson show. You see how they don't just use one label, but they pile labels on top of labels. These people are so used to using words in place of logical arguments that they think piling labels on top of labels somehow bolsters their argument. It's just completely insane. You know something? For all this outrage over criticism of a Democrat veteran, they sure don't seem to mind that Duckworth wants to tear down George Washington, one of this country's first and most prolific veterans. That's all for this episode. Please hit that like button, share, and subscribe. If you want to support this channel, you can do so on one of these platforms. You can find all those links in the description and pinned comment. Thanks for watching. Keep coming back.